She was my first boss at Washington State Hospital Association. An executive director of a workers' compensation trust. And Beverly Simmons is somebody I will never forget. For 9 years, Beverly gave me fashion advice, no-fail recipes, taught me how to handle clients, and when to plant petunias. Her best advice, I will always remember, is be ethical and be true to yourself. She hired me for my healthcare safety expertise and experience, and I must have interviewed well because I was immediately assigned to do a presentation at a conference. Because I wanted to make a good first impression, I worked harder than anybody ever knew. And on my big day, when I arrived, clutching a stack of 3x5 cards in my trembling hands, she knew I needed help. And the next day, she called me into her office, gave me some advice, and from that moment on, I was loyal. The Institute of Management Consultants is an organization that is built on a professional network of people who help each other become better consultants and communicators through informal mentoring and coaching. And we've all been coached in some way or mentored in some way in our lives. Mentoring and coaching help us become better at our jobs, gain more satisfaction from our work, and much more. And we're grateful for these people who take time to help us. In the IMCA, in the beginning, we get a warm welcome from a dedicated, I guess, buddy, leading to suggestions and offers to make introductions. People take the time to say hello in online meetings. And working alone, I was pleasantly surprised to find an instant group of colleagues and feedback. As seasoned professionals, we are always striving to get to the next level of expertise. We know as professionals, it's all about continuous quality improvement. And as we work, we get that improvement, but it takes feedback. We never lose sight of our foundation of professional ethics. And whenever we see the need and the other person is willing, we help out. And from helping out, it's just a natural step to informal coaching and mentoring. I believe mentoring someone is a lot like being the ideal big brother or big sister. We watch out for our colleagues. We make sure they feel safe, introduce them to people they should know, and help them out sometimes with a little bit of a nudge. I learned a lot about Beverly and a lot from her. She was always professional, and she shared her best project management tips and tricks. One of the tips I still use today is the wall. I put all my post-it notes and summaries on a timeline on my wall. Now, Beverly liked it, and other people liked it too, because at any moment they could come in and see exactly where I was in the project. And because I knew people were looking, and I was looking, I always made sure I kept on track. Beverly had strong standards, and I know she was the captain of her ship. Along with my two fellow safety consultants, we towed the line. We showed up for meetings on time, and we were prepared. Whenever Beverly walked into our department meeting, she had her binder and the agenda clipped to the front cover, and we knew when she opened up that binder, she was ready to work. It was Beverly who taught me that precision, presentation, and professionalism are everything. Looking forward to my future as a student mentor in the IMCA, I will take the best tips from Beverly and pass them on. I remember she was sometimes no nonsense, but underneath that sometimes brusque exterior, she was kind and she always treated people well and fairly, and she had a great sense of humor. The two best pieces of advice that Beverly gave me were calculate how long it will take and double it. And the next best piece of advice, maybe it could be my best piece of advice, was there is always a fix. You just need to find it. I had excellent and not so excellent bosses. But because my experience as Beverly's protege was so positive, I'm ready to pay it forward by being a student mentor in the IMCA. And the first thing I'll share, always be true to your ethics and yourself.